Been a part of head for a good 6 months now. I made this switch because I think the head really provides control to my game, which I'm looking for. The adaptive string pattern really adds control at the end of my reach when I'm in good lunges, looking for that finesse touch. But it also adds a good amount of power to my shots. I'm trying to put pressure on to the back. So I really love my racket. The slim body gives me a relaxed feel in the grip. It just sits really nicely in the palm of my hand, and I've been trying to relax my grip for a good 8 years now, and I think this is really complimentary of that. The black and gold, it was the first thing that made me go to this racket. I absolutely love the colour of it. Myself being a proud Kiwi, anything black I absolutely love it, and this black and gold combo is really the most beautiful racket I've used. The matte black and then the shiny gold, it just complements each other, and it's a stunning racket. The racket really fits nicely into my palm. The slim body frame is a really relaxed grip for me. It really adds a lot of control to the far reaches of my swing, and the adaptive fan pattern, the string, adds a lot of control. I've been looking for a bit more control in my shots going forward, and this string pattern does exactly that. Just adding that really nice control to my shots, and like I said, at the end of my reach, it just fits into my hand, and it's just an extension to my arm. I like to use my speed to attack, and getting on that volley, the lightweight of the speed 120 really complements that, and it gives me a lot of racket head speed at the end of my reach, and also a lot of control and power as well. So it's a perfect racket for me.
I'm Sam Keeble and I'm part of the community fundraising team at the Brain Tumour Charity. I just wanted to send this message to say a huge, huge thank you to everybody that's involved in the Northern Joes Cup. We're so grateful to all the competitors taking part, to everybody that's come out to support, and to all of those that have enabled this event to go ahead. We're wishing you the very best for the weekend. We can't wait to hear all about it, and thank you so much for shining a light on brain tumours, helping us to raise awareness and vital funds to address this devastating disease. Thank you.
Left. 2-1. You had a line to the ball. 2-1 and a shot split. And out to all. Yes, left. 2-all. Yes, left. 2-all. From the right. Out, 3-2. Yes, round out, 3-3. Four, three. Stroke to Malik. Right box. 5-3. Yes, let. 5-3. Right side. Tomlinson, and out, 4-5. Okay. It's Tomlinson, be very careful. Very careful with that shot. You okay? Left side, left side, 5-5. Out, and out, 6-5. Out, 6-6. And out, 7-6. Left box, 8-6. And out, 7-8. Eight-all. Down. 9-8. and out, 9-0. Up to Tomlinson. No, no, it's a loose ball. You're not hitting your target, it's a loose ball. 10-9. And out, 10-9, game ball. Tomlinson, 11-9. Game to Tomlinson. Tomlinson leads, 2 games to love. Tomlinson leads, 2 games to love. Love all. One love. Yes, left. One love. Malik. And out, one all. One. No let. And out. Two all. And out, 3-2. No let. 4-2 left. No, the ball was long. You went round the front. Got to find the line. 4-2. No let. You need to find the line, ladies. And out. 3-4. You okay? 4-0. Hello. And out, 5-4. Yes, let. 6-4. Left side. 6-4. Left side. And out. 5-6. Six all. Yes, let's. 6-6. a mixture of feet. It's a stroke to Tomlinson. She can't play the shot. Seven, six. Seven, six. Right side. Right. Stroke to Malik. No, no, you're not. And out, seven all. Eight, seven. Yes, let's. Eight, seven. Yes, let's. 8-7. Out. 9-7. Ten, seven, game ball. And out. 8-10, game ball. Nine, ten, game ball. Down. 10-all, playing the swing by 2 points. And out, 11-10, game ball. And out, 11-all. Malik. And out, 12-11, game ball. Okay. 13-11, game to Malik. Thomson leads 2-1. Tomlinson leads 2-1. Malik to serve. Love all. And out one love. No. I didn't see you hit it. I saw you was close, and then you missed it before. And out 4-3. 4-3. And out, 4-4. And out, 5-4. Stroke Tomlinson, 6-4. Yes, left. And out, 5-6. Left box, left, 6-6. Yes, let. Hit you with a racket. 6-6. Okay. Right box. 7-6. And out, 7-8. Yes, let, 7-8. Let's. You okay? Left side, 8-all. Eight all. You okay? No let. And out, 9-8. And out, 9-all. And out, 10-9, game ball. two games all. Malik to serve. Love all. One love. Stroke to Tomlinson. Two love. Out 1-2. Yes, let. Please be careful, there's too much contact. Yes, let. 1-2. And out, 2-3. General traffic. If that's the line to the ball, the tee's not the place to be. You went that way and she wants to come into the corner. 3-3. Out. And out, 4-3. Out 5-4. And out 5-5. Contact. I'm not saying she did, but it's too much contact. You don't need to run in the back. It's a yes let. Find the line, not through the back of the player. Right side. 5-5. 6-5. And out, 6-6. Stroke to Malik. And out, 7-7. You had the work in the shop to play. That was a loose ball. 9-0. Thank you.
But honestly, okay, so I'll let you get your breath, Torrie. So well done for to the final, playing well. How are you feeling about this tournament so far?
Yeah, I feel like I was playing all right. It wasn't my best squash. A couple of decisions I don't agree with from both parts, but I think I did well to mentally stay in that thing for me. So yeah, no, I'm happy that I came through being 2-0 down and winning it 3-2. But yeah, thank you.
Well done, got on good luck tomorrow. Thank you, Torrie. Okay, so moving swiftly on to our second match. So semi-final of the Men's Northern Joe Cup 2022. Calling first onto court and our local favourite from England, the world record of 215, Finlay Withington. And our number one seed with an England ranking of 75, Curtis Malik.
Torrie, Withington leads. One game to lock.
Hi, my name's Evie Ragg. I'm a part of the community fundraising team here at the Brain Tumour Charity. I'd like to start by saying a huge thank you to all involved with the fantastic event that is the PSA Northern Joe's Cup. I would also like to make a few special shout outs to the brilliant Josh Taylor and his team for everything you've done to help make this event happen. And of course, the wonderful Richard and Isaac, whose dedication to utilise the power of sport to spread awareness about brain tumours has made this event even greater in its second year running. Your support is hugely appreciated. Every single donation made by people like you really is bringing us closer to a cure. Every day, 33 people in the UK are diagnosed with a brain tumour. Yet, changes in survival rates have barely improved in 40 years compared with other cancers. Investment in research is low, and diagnosis is still taking much too long. At the Brain Tumour Charity, we know that needs to change, and that's why we're working faster and going further to find a cure for this devastating disease. We recently committed to investing another $40 million into research by 2027, and that's all down.
Withington leads, one game to lock. Love all. Thank you. left box.
Thank you.
from game all. Thank you. The ball. Thank you. 10-5, game ball.
Hi, I'm Sam Keeble and I'm part of the community fundraising team at the Braintree Charity. I just wanted to send this message to say a huge, huge thank you to everybody that's involved in the Northern Joes Cup. We're so grateful to all the competitors taking part, to everybody that's come out to support, and to all of those that have enabled this event to go ahead. We're wishing you the very best for the weekend. We can't wait to hear all about it, and thank you so much for shining a light on brain tumours, helping us to raise awareness and vital funds to address this devastating disease. Thank you.
Thank you.
next one. Well done, Curtis, into another final. You're happy with where you're playing?
Yeah, just started a little bit slow, just firing it in pretty well. Just once I got my length back a little bit and just started being a bit more aggressive. Got myself into the match nicely there, so it's good.
You're obviously enjoying your squash and looking really strong and fit. You're happy and healthy at the moment with it all, yeah?
Yeah, it's nice to actually be injury-free for like a period of at least 6 months. When I was like when junior, 17 to 20, I was played with injuries, but like the last 2 years where I've been injury-free. Yeah, it's good.
Hope that continues for the time to come, and we'll see you tomorrow in the final. Well done, Curtis. Thank you very much. Before we get the next match on in a couple of minutes, just before we do so, just after this next match, we'll do a chuck a ball challenge. Those that aren't aware of it, you can buy some numbered balls for £1. We'll put a target in the middle. The nearest to the target gets a whole bag of goodies, including squash kit from sort of Dunlop and Head, etc. So if you want to buy a numbered ball, Isaac and Sam have got the balls, so to speak. There's also raffle tickets, and we'll draw the raffle a little bit later on. Next match will be on in around 2 minutes.
been a part of head for a good 6 months now. I made this switch because I think, you know, the head really provides control to my game, which I'm looking for. The adaptive string pattern really adds control at the end of my reach when I'm in good lunges, looking for that finesse touch. But it also adds a good amount of power to my shots. I'm trying to put pressure on to the back. So I really love my racket. The slim body gives me a relaxed feel in the grip. It just sits really nicely in the palm of my hand, and I've been trying to relax my grip for a good 8 years now, and I think this is really complimentary of that. The black and gold, it was the first thing that made me go to this racket. I absolutely love the colour of it. Myself being a proud Kiwi, anything black I absolutely love it, and this black and gold combo is really the most beautiful racket I've used. You know, the matte black and then the shiny gold, it just complements each other, and it's a stunning racket. The racket really fits nicely into my palm. The slim body frame is a really relaxed grip for me. It really adds a lot of control to the far reaches of my swing, and you know, the adaptive fan pattern, the string, adds a lot of control. I've been looking for, you know, a bit more control in my shots going forward, and this string pattern does exactly that. You know, just adding that really nice control to my shots, and like I said, at the end of my reach, it just fits into my hand, and it's just an extension to my arm. I like to use my speed to attack, and getting on that volley, the lightweight. Okay,
so moving on to our next match, our second semi-final in the women's draw of the 2022 Northern Joe Cup. First onto court, our number 4 seed and world 109 from England, Saran and Nghiem. And next on court, our number 2 seed from Scotland with a world ranking of 76, Alison Thomson.
Hi, I'm Sam Keeble and I'm part of the community fundraising team at the Braintree Charity. I just wanted to send this message to say a huge, huge thank you to everybody that's involved in the Northern Joes Cup. We're so grateful to all the competitors taking part, to everybody that's come out to support, and to all of those that have enabled this event to go ahead. We're wishing you the very best for the weekend. We can't wait to hear all about it, and thank you so much for shining a light on brain tumours, helping us to raise awareness and vital funds to address this devastating disease. Thank you.
Northern Joe Cup 2022 women's semi-final match. Saran, Nghiem of England to serve, Alison, Thomson of Scotland to receive. Best of five games. Love all. Seven, three. One game to love. The ball. Ball up. Love. And out. 1-6. Right box. 3-6. Six. 5-6. 6 all. And out, 7-6. And out, 7-9. And out, 10-7, game ball. And out, 8-10, game ball. And out, 8-10, game ball. Thank you. by 2 points.
Let's go, Saran.
Okay, and out, 11-10, game ball. Nghiem leads 2-0. Love all. One. 7-2. Thomson and out 3-8. Five, 10, match ball.
Well played, Saran. Into a final in the home club, I guess. Playing well, happy?
Yeah, really happy. Happy to get through. Obviously, it was a tough match for me. And yeah, just happy to get through in front of the crowd, which have been amazing help. So thanks for everyone to come out. So.
There you go. So obviously, appreciation from the crowd. So obviously, playing Torrie, which you've played before, I imagine, a few times. So a good match tomorrow, yes?
Yeah, looking forward to it. Another big battle. you.
Right, listen, well done, thank you. We'll see you later on.
So, we're going to do the chuckle ball challenge before we get on to the final match of the evening. So, if you've bought your balls from Isaac and Sam, if you get hold of them now, as it were, and they'll set the target up and they'll let you know how what they're going to do. And we'll do that in the next minute or so.
Okay then. Shabba. Oh, cut.
Oh. All right. Hey.
Anyone that wants a pair of balls can go upstairs and see Sam.
Catch?
Actually, anyone that's paid for balls, they're all at the top. Go and collect them. Can you remember what numbers are on your balls, please? That's really important. That's just a life lesson. Has everyone got their balls? All right. All right, we good? Okay, nearest to the eye on the brain wins. How about it, lads?
Marcus.
Big round of applause, please, for Marcus.
I'm a part of the community fundraising team here at the Brain Tumor Charity. I'd like to start by saying a huge thank you to all involved with the fantastic event that is the PSA Northern Joe's Cup. I would also like to make a few special shout outs to the brilliant Josh Taylor and his team for everything you've done to help make this event happen. And of course, the wonderful Richard and Isaac, whose dedication to utilise the power of sport to spread awareness about brain tumours has made this event even greater in its second year running. Your support is hugely appreciated. Every single donation made by people like you really is bringing us closer to a cure. Every day, 33 people in the UK are diagnosed with a brain tumour. Yet, changes in survival rates have barely improved in 40 years compared with other cancers. Investment in research is low, and diagnosis is still taking much too long. At the Brain Tumour Charity, we know that needs to change, and that's why we're working faster and going further to find a cure for this devastating disease. We recently committed to investing another $40 million into research by 2027, and that's all down to the donations and the fundraising activities of our community, who've sadly been affected by the loss of a loved one or inspired by someone who is living with. So a big thank you to Richard and Isaac, who have been the driving force behind this event, and to all that have been involved in making it happen. And to everyone who has come along to support, I hope you have a fantastic time. Everything you are doing really does make a difference. So thank you.
So it's the third event that we've held here at GML. So we've got a good team of volunteers that are all upskilled in their different jobs now for things like the streaming and just the general running of the venue around in event time. So we've built up from a closed satellite PSA event up to the different tiers, so 3K last time, now 5K. So we've just been working with that team really to make sure they're all ready. Obviously the different bit of this event is the charity aspect, so there's been a lot of trying to promote the awareness of the charity through the event, through building the awareness of the event as it's coming up.
We lost our son Joseph to a brain tumour back in January of 2020. And we've been raising money for charity ever since. We set up the Northern Joe's Fund within the Brain Tumour Charity. But also, Joe's brother Isaac has been a big part of the squash fraternity. He played a lot of squash in his juniors, he's still playing now. So we thought we'd like to give a little bit back to the sport, but also raise some awareness around brain tumours. So we thought sponsoring the PSA event would be the best way to do that. Isaac is also a junior ambassador for the charity as well. This is really about raising awareness, a little bit back to the sport that's helped and supported Joe's brother, and again, having some great squash hopefully during the course of the week.
Obviously we've had a bit of start-up capital to be able to get this event underway with the prize pot and working with that aspect. But what we've found is, A, we've built huge awareness for the charity locally and in the club as we've gone about delivering it, but we're now starting to get to the point where we've raised quite a lot of money and nearly starting to tip over to making a lot more money for the charity than just the start-up amount in the prize fund. So it'd be really interesting to see if this model can be delivered and raise a lot more money for charity, which I think we'll start to do as we get through the event now with all the various initiatives that we've got on around the event. So yeah, it'd be a really interesting one to see how this has gone. Certainly think there's a place for it moving forward. As we said, it's all linked to the Brain Tune charity and the work they do. Fantastic cause, do a lot of great stuff. We're taking donations through the Just Giving link, which can be found throughout all the streaming. There's videos and promotional aspects around the Brain Tune charity. And our Just Giving link is, if you search for Northern Joker, you'll find us there.
Been a part of head for a good 6 months now. I made this switch because I think, you know, the head really provides control to my game, which I'm looking for. The adaptive string pattern really adds control at the end of my reach when I'm in good lunges, looking for that finesse touch. But it also adds a good amount of power to my shots. I'm trying to put pressure on to the back. So I really love my racket. The slim body gives me a relaxed feel in the grip. It just sits really nicely in the palm of my hand, and I've been trying to relax my grip for a good 8 years now, and I think this is really complimentary of that. The black and gold, it was the first thing that made me go to this racket. I absolutely love the colour of it. Myself being a proud Kiwi, anything black I absolutely love it, and this black and gold combo is really the most beautiful racket I've used. You know, the matte black and then the shiny gold, it just complements each other, and it's a stunning racket. The racket really fits nicely into my palm. The slim body frame is a really relaxed grip for me. It really adds a lot of control to the far reaches of my swing, and you know, the adaptive fan pattern, the string, adds a lot of control. I've been looking for, you know, a bit more control in my shots going forward, and this string pattern does exactly that. You know, just adding that really nice control to my shots, and like I said, at the end of my reach, it just fits into my hand, and it's just an extension to my arm. I like to use my speed to attack, and getting on that volley, the lightweight of the speed 120 really complements that, and it gives me you know, a lot of racket head speed at the end of my reach, and also a lot of control and power as well. So it's the perfect racket for me.
Hi, I'm Sam Keeble and I'm part of the community fundraising team at the Brain Tumor Charity. I just wanted to send this message to say a huge, huge thank you to everybody that's involved in the Northern Joes Cup. We're so grateful to all the competitors taking part, to everybody that's come out to support, and to all of those that have enabled this event to go ahead. We're wishing you the very best for the weekend. We can't wait to hear all about it, and thank you so much for shining a light on brain tumours, helping us to raise awareness and vital funds to address this devastating disease. Thank you.
name's Evie Ragg. I'm a part of the community fundraising team here at the Brain Tumor Charity. I'd like to start by saying a huge thank you to all involved with the fantastic event that is the PSA Northern Joe's Cup. I would also like to make a few special shout outs to the brilliant Josh Taylor and his team for everything you've done to help make this event happen. And of course, the wonderful Richard and Isaac, whose dedication to utilise the power of sport to spread awareness about brain tumours has made this event even greater in its second year running. Your support is hugely appreciated. Every single donation made by people like you really is bringing us closer to a cure. Every day, 33 people in the UK are diagnosed with a brain tumour. Yet, changes in survival rates have barely improved in 40 years compared with other cancers. Investment in research is low, and diagnosis is still taking much too long. At the Brain Tumour Charity, we know that needs to change, and that's why we're working faster and going further to find a cure for this devastating disease. We recently committed to investing another $40 million into research by 2027, and that's all down to the donations and the fundraising activities of our community who've sadly been affected by the loss of a loved one or inspired by someone who is living with. So a big thank you to Richard and Isaac, who have been the driving force behind this event, and to all that have been involved in making it happen. And to everyone who has come along to support, I hope you have a fantastic time. Everything you are doing really does make a difference. So thank you.
So it's the third event that we've held here at GML. So we've got a good team of volunteers that are all upskilled in their different jobs now for things like streaming and just the general running of the venue around an event time. So we've built up from a closed satellite PSA event up to the different tiers, so 3K last time, now 5K. So we've just been working with that team really to make sure they're all ready. Obviously the different bit of this event is the charity aspect, so there's been a lot of trying to promote the awareness of the charity through the event, through building the awareness of the event as it's coming up.
We lost our son Joseph to a brain tumour back in January of 2020. And we've been raising money for charity ever since. We set up the Northern Joe's Fund within the Brain Tumour Charity. But also, Joe's brother Isaac has been a big part of the squash fraternity. He played a lot of squash in his juniors, he's still playing now. So we thought we'd like to give a little bit back to the sport, but also raise some awareness around brain tumours. So we thought sponsoring a PSA event would be the best way to do that. Isaac is also a junior ambassador for the charity as well. This is really about raising awareness, a little bit back to the sport that's helped and supported Joe's brother, and again, having some great squash hopefully during the course of the week.
Obviously we've had a bit of start-up capital to be able to get this event underway with the prize pot and working with that aspect. But what we've found is, A, we've built huge awareness for the charity locally and in the club as we've gone about delivering it, but we're now starting to get to the point where we've raised quite a lot of money and nearly starting to tip over to making a lot more money for the charity than just the start-up amount in the prize fund. So it'd be really interesting to see if this model can be delivered and raise a lot more money for charity, which I think we'll start to do as we get through the event now with all the various initiatives that we've got on around the event. So it'd be a really interesting one to see how this has gone. Certainly think there's a place for it moving forward. As we said, it's all linked to the Brain Tumour Charity and the work they do. Fantastic.
Okay, for our final match of this evening, so the final semi-final of the Northern Joe Cup 2022. If you welcome the players on court, please. Our first player, and both these players are unseeded at the start of the event, so we'll get an unseeded player in the final. From Scotland, world number 208, Alasdair Prott. This is a bit of a Celtic battle, this one. So from Wales, point number 157, Elliott Morris Devred.
Northern Joe Cup 2022 men's semi-final match. Alasdair, Prott of Scotland to Sturve. Elliott, Morris, Devred of Wales to receive. Best of 5 games. Love all. Out 2-1 3-1. Right, box. 6-3. Right. 6-3. Thank you.
7-3. Thirty seconds. Horace Lee, one game to love.
Head and four, game to Morris, Devred. Devred leads 2 games to lock.
We'll be right back.
Right box.
Crowd might have gone, but there's a lot on the live stream still, Elliott. So at least they've stayed on to watch. So listen, through to a final, unseeded at the start, but playing really well. Happy with that?
Of course, yeah. I mean, Alasdair's a good player, so it's nice to just get off in three. I've had a good tournament so far, and just hopefully got one more push now and pull through.
Looking forward to playing Curtis tomorrow. Be a big one, and hopefully get a decent crowd as well.
Yeah, I mean, we grew up in juniors together. We played loads when we were younger. he's in form at the moment, so it'll be a really good game. I mean, I'm going to get stuck in and kind of see how it goes from there, really.
So. Well, let's look forward, but let you go and get warmed down. Look forward to seeing you. Thank you very much, Elliott. And, right, thank you, everyone, and good night from this evening.